folks, so I see some chat in the chat talking about who should come back to Doctor Who proper, and we had a few people mention Bernard Cribbins, and it's like, folks, what are you on about? Bernard Cribbins already returned to Doctor Who in a, you guessed it, a bloody Big Finish audio drama. This is like the first time I've ever ordered something packaged from the Big Finish website. And I ordered this. This is the 10th Doctor Adventures Volume 3, starring David Tennant, Catherine Tate, and Bernard Cribbins returning as Wilf. The reason I got this is because Doctor Who Magazine, the latest issue, had a coupon code for this limited edition set. You see the sticker on the back, it's a limited edition. This is number 4,837 out of 5,000. I don't know if you can see that. And dual song Bernard back on screen, not just Big Finish. I know what you meant. But there's always that. But yeah, Bernard Cribbins is wonderful. You're going to get a lot of Bernard Cribbins appreciation in the next few installments of the top 50 Doctor Who scenes marathon that I've been doing. Scott Gerrard says, I forgot to claim that. I think the offer is still there until like the beginning of January. So you've got time if stock is still remaining. TFL Creative Media says, is the Big Finish box the same size of a DVD box? No, this is bigger. 2 seconds, I'll just grab a generic Blu-ray and DVD. This is the 10th Doctor Volume 3. This is like a limited edition thing. Not all Big Finish stories come in this size. They're normally standard CD cases, I believe. So yeah, this is the DVD of Downtime, if you can see the comparison. So bigger than a DVD, thicker than a DVD as well. Look at that thickness as well. And here is My Hero Academia Season 1 on Blu-ray, which is, of course, even smaller than the DVD. So there's your size comparison. Alex Rooney Composer returned. What have you missed? Depends when you left, really. I don't know when you left. We've not really done much since the five-minute break, other than shameless self-promotion, the thickness and girth of David Tennant's third volume. Someone else who's going to be very, very busy over the next 9 years, to be exact, is Big Finish, who had their license renewed to do more Doctor Who audio dramas guaranteed until 2030. So Big Finish Productions, in association with BBC Studios, is delighted to confirm that its license to make original Doctor Who and spin-off audio adventures has been extended until the 31st of March 2030. So, Jan Patterson, director of books and audio at BBC Studios, said, our partnership with Big Finish has been going for over 20 years. Over this time, the team there has created the most extensive range of original Doctor Who audio dramas and readings, working with the original cast. This renewal of our long-term license secures our partnership to allow Big Finish to create fantastic new adventures for the Doctors and their friends for many more years. So, Big Finish got the Doctor Who license back in 1999. So this has been a very long-standing relationship, and obviously this press release, this announcement, is kind of just publicity, as in a prerequisite. They have to do it. I don't think there was any doubt that this license was not going to be renewed. This was obviously going to happen. This is obviously going to continue, but it seems that the deal has been done. The deal has been placed, and everything's been signed on the dotted line to confirm more Doctor Who Big Finish dramas until 2030. Let's hear from Jason Haig-Ellery, who's the Big Finish chairman and co-executive producer, who says, we are very grateful to the BBC for once again placing their faith in Big Finish and extending our license into another decade, this time up to 2030. This is the interesting bit. This allows us to really plan ahead and create long-term storylines and character development, not just for the Doctors and the Companions, but also for new series and elements that we can't talk about yet. We are excited about the next decade and the adventures we're going to create in the TARDIS for us all to enjoy together. And, you know, there's more statements. We've got one here from Nicholas Briggs as well, who is going to be very, very busy and very, very happy. And we've also got just some more details for some of their upcoming releases, which we'll talk about in a moment. But yeah, so it's interesting, now that they do have the confirmation for the next 8.5 to 9 years, up until March 31st, 2030, then Big Finish are really, really able to plan ahead. And it's interesting that Jason Haig-Ellery, the Big Finish chairman, teases new series elements that they can't quite talk about yet, which they've got the Martha Jones box set, so it doesn't necessarily have to be a new Doctor, such as, like, you know, Matt Smith, Peter Capaldi, or Jodie Whittaker, although that would be awesome. It could be a companion, you know, it could be Bill's Adventures with Heather, or something like that. Yeah, the possibilities are literally endless. Up until the current run of the show, right now, as far as I understand it, and feel free to prove me wrong or provide counter evidence, but as I understand it, Big Finish legally cannot use anything from the current era of the show, from Peter Capaldi onwards, basically. That's why there's no 13th Doctor audio dramas or anything from Big Finish. That's why there's no Yaz or Dan or Graham, Ryan, Jericho, as somebody said in the chat as well. That's kind of how it goes. The BBC gets first dibs on everything, and then Big Finish will only be able to do Jodie Whittaker 13th Doctor era stories, Fugitive Doctor stories as well. We've got Fugitive and the Division, as mentioned by Alex Rooney Composer in the chat. They have to wait until that era is over before they can start doing stuff like that. However, and obviously, I have no evidence for this, but it would not surprise me if unofficially they had maybe, you know, Nicholas Briggs has been on set with Jodie, I imagine, at some point, because he voices the Daleks and things like that, and they've been on set with Jodie. It would not surprise me if at some point over coffee at the tea urn or something at the catering stand, Nicholas Briggs has said, hey, would you be interested at some point? And Jodie's like, yeah, you know, contact me at the time. I imagine that's probably, legally speaking, the furthest they can take those conversations. But because Big Finish tend to plan ahead years and years into the future, like we've got Fourth Doctor adventures which have been confirmed for the next few months, but they were recorded back in 2017, I believe. We'll talk about one of those in a minute. So that they plan so far in advance and so far ahead that it wouldn't surprise me if just under the table they had 13th Doctor era scripts that they haven't like legally been able to sign off of, they've got ideas, they've got concepts and stuff in mind. It wouldn't surprise me if that was the case, because Big Finish, they love stories, you know what they're like, they love those stories. Even if you weren't able to chat with Jodie on set, Nick Briggs is Chibnall's next door neighbour, so he'll probably be able to get them together and talk. Are they neighbours? Are they really neighbours? That's so cool. And Jason Lescali says, Dan Van Easter. So the best part about the audio format is that we don't have to see Dan Van Easter, okay? We don't have to see Dan Van Easter. I'm very sorry to drag the conversation down. But now that we are in the guttural pit, basically, let's just wallow a little bit more through the filth, okay? Let's stay down in the tar and the dirt, okay? Because they had an announcement, Big Finish, this past week for the cast and the plot and the writers for the first Fourth Doctor box set that's going to be coming out next year, in March 2022. It's a Fourth Doctor solo box set called Solo, and this takes place during the period of time between The Deadly Assassin and The Face of Evil, where the Fourth Doctor, having lost Sarah Jane before he meets Leela, is travelling alone. And this box set got announced, it all seems really cool. We've got a cover here, it's called Solo, comes out in March. We've got some great writers on board, Timothy X Attack and David Llewellyn, for stories called Blood of the Time Lords and The Ravencliff, which seems really cool. So, unfortunately, you'll notice a name down here at the bottom, James Dreyfuss, as part of the cast list. And James Dreyfuss, you folks will know, massively reactionary, transphobic dude. He's also been a highlight, shall we say, on GB News, which, for those of you who don't know, GB News is the fake news network, kind of like trying to be an answer to Fox News, who, this past week, according to the BARB and the press outlets and stuff, have a registered viewership on many days of literally zero, which means that this live stream being viewed by over 140 people, and I'm sure those 140 people will go out of their way to like this video as well, massively appreciated, but yeah, this live stream is viewed significantly more than GB News in the UK, which I massively appreciate. So there was of course talk of whether or not you support and buy this release. Now here's the rub however, this was recorded in May, June, and July of 2017. This will have been recorded almost 5 years prior to its release, before all of this stuff was kind of known about James Dreyfuss. And because of contractual stuff, they still have to release it. I don't think they can recast him. I don't think they can throw the whole baby out with the bathwater. I think there may be some contract issues. They still have to release this thing. And even if they were to recast, James Dreyfuss got paid anyway. Things like that. And Dr. Bonnie, no, I'm not kidding. Zero viewership. Literally zero. There's like maybe a couple of people are watching, but the actual statistical term is zero viewers. Like, as in, the number is so insignificant, it's basically zero viewers. Scott Jarrett asks, do you think they could have replaced him? Maybe not without sorting out a contract. Curiosity Rocks asks, why did they wait so long to release it? I think it's because Tom Baker, he's old, he's getting on a little bit. I think they just want to get as many stories recorded with Tom Baker as possible. Record as much with Tom Baker while he's still able, while he's still wanting to play the Fourth Doctor, and just, you know, record all of these adventures to release for years to come. If we go into their Big Finish page for the Fourth Doctor adventures, the last scheduled release with Tom Baker and Christopher Naylor, who plays Harry Sullivan, is September 2024. This was recorded in October 2020. They do these 4 or 5 years in advance. So, for the Fourth Doctor, it is not unheard of, and it makes sense to plan ahead to such an extent. The Ninth Doctor has finished recording, Christopher Eccleston has finished recording for adventures that are going to be coming out at the beginning of 2023, or like, the middle of 2023. So, yeah. So, we're not quite sure, as fans, shall we say, as internet sleuths, as to whether or not James Drayford has many more releases. This, you know, he played the Master in the Psychic Circus, the Home Guard in the First Doctor Adventures. This is the reason I've not picked up the First Doctor Adventures, because of Dreyfus. So, folks, and this is not a trick question. I just want to, you know, I just want to, like, read the room here, and there is no right answer, okay? There is no right answer. Andrew says Dreyfus didn't say anything transphobic. He objectively did, but okay. So, let's just read the room. Would it be okay to just not review this because of one of the actors who recorded this literally 5 years prior to its broadcast, and they have to release it out of contractual obligation, but they're not going to be working with Dreyfus anymore in the near future? They've not renewed any contracts, they've not done anything like that. They've not renewed contracts with James Dreyfus. In fact, Dreyfus has gone on, like, GB News, as I said, you know, zero viewership GB News, to complain that he's no longer being hired at Big Finish. So this is kind of like, no more harm can be done in this particular field. Like, at first when I heard this, I was like, nah, I'm definitely not listening to this. But then when I looked more deeply into it, and that this was recorded in 2017, and also, like, because Dreyfus is just one name on this list, you know, Tom Baker, Annette Chadland, Badland, Trevor Cooper, Neri Hughes, Adrian Lucas, written by Timothy Exetac, David Llewellyn, so great writers, of course, directed by Nicholas Briggs, John Dorney, script editing. This is guaranteed to be a good box set, okay? And it's not even the fact that I think that James Dreyfus is a good actor. I've hardly listened or seen anything that Dreyfus has ever done. This is purely a moral thing. This isn't even a talent thing. I have no idea. So, I don't know. I don't think... Basically, if this comes out in March 2022 and your favourite WhoTubers or people are reviewing it or listening to it or talking about it, don't, like, dogpile them because, oh, you've supported James Dreyfus, because it seems like the actual material gain and material harm has already been done, if that makes sense. It's not like if you buy this set, they're hiring Dreyfus again. It's not like buying this set will enable Dreyfus to continue doing what he does and spreading the rhetoric that he does, and also just randomly harassing people on Twitter by the looks of it. Like, he's constantly responding to people on Twitter. Dude's easily triggered. He's easily triggered. And he gets cancelled and silenced, which is why he then goes on GB News to talk about how silenced he is. Although he might as well be silenced. If anybody does a spot on GB News to complain about how they're being silenced, are they actually being heard? No, because zero viewership. Greg Henrique says, does he get royalties from it? That is a question significantly above my pay grade. So, I've no idea. I don't think he does. I don't think Big Finish operates like that. Especially because it seems like Dreyfus is just... Oh no, he is playing the Master in this. He's playing the Master, Haku, Cohort, and Mandelbrot, so multiple characters in this. It seems like there's a race called the Cohort. Like, Jane Slavin is here as well, playing a Cohort. Christopher Naylor playing a Cohort. Like, awesome, awesome cast. Do we drag this down, or do we not talk about it, or listen to it, or support Big Finish? Because of one dude. There is no right answer. So I think what's going to happen is that come March time, I probably will... You know, depending on my budget, I probably will check it out. You know, also depends on what's coming out next year as well. And, you know, just be upfront about it. Would you folks hate me if I did that? Like, I think my loyalties and my, my politics are, like, well out there, like, on the table and things like that. And Curiosity Rock says you can review the story and the characters and ignore his part. Like, yeah, I don't think I would ignore his part, but I don't think you wouldn't see that as, like, some sort of tacit endorsement or anything. But this is the question that you sort of have to ask when you're bloody grown up, and I hate it. Obviously, we'll cross the bridge properly when we come to it, but yeah, I wasn't even planning to talk about this. I just remembered this when talking about the Big Finish deal. So yeah, but it seems like Dreyfuss isn't going to be doing any more work with Big Finish. People on Twitter were saying that this was the very, like, last scheduled release of his to come out. So maybe this is the last time Dreyfuss will be gracing Big Finish's ears. So yeah, let's talk about someone who is intensely and lovingly supportive of trans rights. Let's talk about Russell T Davies, because we got official story details for his lost story, his untold 1980s story, Mind of the Hodiak. And we've got some casting announcements as well. We've got a cover here as well. Who's the cover by? The cover is by Sophie Cowdery. Of course it's Sophie. Wonderful work from Sophie as usual. I should have recognized that color work. I absolutely should have recognized that. That's my fault. In the depths of space, the mysterious Hodiak is manipulating the Galactic Stock Exchange to raise money, his aim to hire mercenaries for a deadly quest across the stars. Meanwhile, on Earth, an ordinary British family is plagued by a series of psychic events. The one thing connecting these events is a magnificent patchwork coat, which just so happens to belong to the Doctor. We got some casting news here. Annette Badland as well. She's getting everywhere, and it's absolutely wonderful to see. Colin Baker, Bonnie Langford, of course, but also the one that raised many, many eyebrows. She's on the front cover, Tania Miller. And I posted this on Twitter as well. Folks, you've seen this before on social media, you know, when Big Finish announces a cast member for their audio dramas, and the mainstream media is like, yeah, we know exactly what we're going to do. Radio Times posting this story: Tania Miller cast in new Russell T Davies Doctor Who story. No other context, that's the headline. And then people will be like, oh, is Tania Miller going to be in the new TV series of Russell T Davies? Oh no, it's Big Finish. They know what they're doing. They know exactly what they're doing. Scott Gerrard says, crazy that we're getting fan fiction from an official writer of the show. Yeah, this could have been the straw that broke the camel's back for Russ T. Davies returning to the world of Doctor Who. This is his warm-up act. This is his warm-up act. Well, the warm-up act. So the stretching before an exercise was the lockdown scripts. This is the warm-up. And then the actual exercise itself will be Doctor Who. Tony Parker says, do you think it will tie in with Series 12? What a flex that would be, right? Okay, so Russ T Davies, one of the best creative minds working in this country, like on this planet, shall we say, in TV. And he's returning to Doctor Who, one of the biggest shows on the planet. And in order to understand what's going to be happening in Series 14, you need to have listened to this Sixth Doctor and Mel story from Big Finish that also co-stars Tania Miller. To answer your question, Tony, I don't think it will tie into Series 14, but that would be an ultimate Chad move. Speaking of Chads, we got some casting announcements for Doctor Who Peladon, which is going to be coming out next month. Now, this was a series that I was not particularly interested in. You know, Peladon, the stories from the Third Doctor era are fine, you know, it's all right. But we also got some announcements that Colin Baker, Paul McGann, and Alex Kingston and Bonnie Langford are going to be in this release as well. We also got some writers' announcements. We've got The Ordeal of Peladon by Jonathan Barnes and Robert Valentine, The Poison of Peladon by Lizzie Hopley, The Death of Peladon by Mark Wright, and The Truth of Peladon by Tim Foley. Full disclosure, one of the producers, the assistant producer of this is Dominic G. Martin, who is a friend of the live stream. So, full disclosure there. But yeah, so Peladon, I guess I'm going to be picking this up next month. But Alex Kingston, Scott Gerrard says Alex Kingston certainly loves being over at Big Finish, doesn't she? Absolutely, yeah. She seems like a random inclusion to have there. But I don't think this is going to be a multi-doctor thing. I think it's going to be separate stories. River Song is going to be in the second one. Sixth Doctor and Mel is going to be in the third one. The Eighth Doctor is going to be in the fourth one. And the first one seems to be mainly centered around King Peladon, who's played by David Troughton. We got some more information for the third War Doctor Begins box set. It's called Battlegrounds. This is getting released in May 2022. We've got three stories in this. We've got The Keeper of Light by Phil Mulrine, Temesis by Russell McPhillips, and Rewind by Timothy Exetax. So this is going to be coming out in May 2022, and we got a confirmation that Ken Bones is going to be reprising his role as Legend Dude here. I forget his character's name, but Ken Bones is returning to the Time War. Uniqueness 35, Fan of Imagination, says, how are they still doing War Doctor stories? John Hurt passed away years ago. Here's the thing, folks. He's being played by the great Jonathan Carley, who was a voice actor in the fandom for several years. And he has been playing the War Doctor he spent some time in fan audios. Full disclosure, he was my Bradley Walsh in the Collateral of Ivanhoe drama that I did a couple of years ago. Or was it last year? Feels so long ago, but yeah, so last year, and he's the War Doctor. He does an incredible John Hurt impression. If you stick around, we'll play a clip when we review Warbringer, because I listened to that this past week. We're going to be reviewing that later on. So yeah, we've got all of that big finish stuff to look forward to over the coming months.